There are a lot of final expense and mortgage protection IMOs that are competing in our industry. The trick is to find one that really fits your needs and goals. Now, some companies recruit agents by promoting the dream of being wealthy. Others advertise the highest commission levels you can get. You name it, someone's recruiting to it. In this video, we're going to go over three telltale signs of the type of insurance marketing organization that you may actually want to avoid. Coming up after this. Dude, roll it, man. I'm Douglas Massi, and when we first decided to enter the final expense sales industry, Mariana, my wife, and I hit a lot of walls. You see, I had already been selling life insurance products for years. The product that I was actually selling back then and the lead program I was working got scratched. I found myself totally hung out to dry. We ended up going from one IMO to the next in search of fair commissions, final expense sales training, and of course, a decent direct mail lead program. Eventually, we decided we were just better off doing it all on our own. We ended up matching a strong direct mail leads program with a field marketing organization and actually ended up sandwiching ourselves right in between. Within just a few months of doing that, I became one of the highest producing final expense agents in the country, averaging over $35,000 in annualized premium every single month. Now, this was back in 2014. That's when we decided to form United Final Expense Services. Mariana and I decided that we would rather be a small insurance marketing organization that specializes in offering agents basically everything that we didn't have, yet everything that we needed to be successful. Advanced final expense sales training, first year commission level starting at 100% and even higher with some products, and giving agents access to multiple lead programs, including the direct mail leads program that put us on the map. Guys, this is not some kind of commercial advertisement. The reason that I'm bringing this all up to you is because we didn't just hop into final expense sales and become successful overnight. There were some serious struggles. Part of the problem was with the IMOs that we started with. Our success came from limited outside help. Let me be clear, guys, you do not need to have the same struggles that we went through. So, before I get into the three warning signs of the type of insurance marketing organization that you may actually want to avoid, here's how you can get a lot of basic training. Simply subscribe to our channel, Final Expense Trainer. Go to our playlists. Click on the playlist called Basic Training and just let the dang videos roll. They're gonna cover all the basics on how to set appointments, door knocking leads, how to field underwrite, building rapport, and a whole lot more. With all that being said, let's get into the video. If you'd like to be notified every time we put out a new training video, just click on that little bell looking thing that's next to the subscribe button. The first warning sign may have already happened to you. A family member or friend told you that you need to go to this awesome, amazing meeting because it could change your life. Then you get to the meeting and of course, they're pimping a multi-level marketing deal. You're gonna hear stories about success and how easy it is. And then they tell you about this next meeting and they tell you to make sure you bring your family and friends. When it comes to an MLM-based organization, you tell me who's gonna make a good living. The guys that are at the top or the new people that are at the bottom trying to work their way to the middle. Some people can be successful at this, but we're talking about very few. If you have that super strong work ethic and tend to be the type of person who is often number one or at least one of the best at everything you do, you may be successful at this type of final expense or mortgage protection operation. Before we get into number two, if you're interested in getting a copy of the Memorial Planning Guide that we leave with all of our clients, stick around until the end of this video. I'll show you exactly how to get this PDF file so you can print these out for your own clients. Sign number two, the company that you're dealing with or thinking about working under is very vague about the commission levels, or they're having you sign up without any upfront or written first year commission levels. They're making claims and statements like, if you come on board with us, you can end up with first year commission levels at 140%. This tends to be the carrot on the stick scenario, where the commission levels on most of their products start out far below 100%, and most of these agents will never see 100%, let alone 140%. If you would like to know exactly what your first year commission levels are, all you need to do is call the carrier and ask them to send you a copy of your commission schedule. If the carrier tells you to get it from your upline, you're probably not getting the first year commissions that you think you're getting, and the insurance carrier may have actually gotten specific directions from your IMO not to give you the commission schedule. Yeah, this kind of shady stuff happens in our industry, and as far as I'm concerned, it's shameless. These dirtbags need to be outed. Sign number three, you're paying for leads and your commission levels are under 100%. Now, understandably, there is a give and take that does go on with a lot of the better or more legitimate insurance agencies. Some companies give you truly discounted or subsidized leads, and in return, your commission levels are less than if you were getting your own leads and paying full price for them. This is totally fair and makes sense for a new agent that doesn't want to learn on their own pay or that doesn't want to learn and pay full price for their leads while they're learning. You can purchase direct mail leads for final expense for around $30 each. Direct mail mortgage protection leads tend to be a little expensive and actually cost around $50 or $55 each. For final expense, you can get high quality telemarketing leads for around $15 to $20 bucks each. Facebook leads are less common, but they usually go for around $20 or $30 bucks a pop. There's another give and take that is very common when it comes to our industry pertaining to training. If you're going to a local office each day where they're actually working with you and training you, well, time is money. To me, it's only fair that you lose some of your commission for this type of training. After all, they're teaching you a career. Going back to that sign number three, if you're learning the business from your own home and you're paying 30 bucks for each direct mail lead, there's no reason for your commission levels to be under 100%, as this is usually not a sensible exchange. Guys, if you're interested in finding out how our final expense sales program works, and we're talking about commission levels starting between 100 and 120%, along with access to some of the strongest lead programs in the entire industry, email me at Doug at UFESonline.com. Happy hunting!